Hello, and welcome to the fifth video in the Getting Started with the STA UHD Producer Plugin video tutorial series. The UHD Producer Plugin, made by Sonicteer Audio, is a new panning plugin that allows for flexible panning and monitoring of immersive formats that Pro Tools doesn't directly support. With audio formats that require extensive speaker setups, it's impractical to have every sound design studio or editing room fully outfitted throughout a large post-production facility. What is needed is another way of monitoring that is lower cost and uses less space. That's where binaural headphone monitoring comes in. This tutorial will discuss how to use binaural monitoring with the STA UHD Producer plugin. To make the best use of this feature, it's important to understand the difference between a stereo downmix of a surround mix and a binaural headphone mix. A stereo downmix of a surround mix is best defined as a reproduction of a multi-channel mix using a fewer number of channels than the original mix. A common use of the term would be a stereo output of a 5.1 surround mix. The purpose of downmixing in this kind of situation is to give the listener the ability to enjoy a mix, for example a 5.1 mix, through a simpler monitoring system, for example two stereo speakers. It's important to know that surround isn't simulated in this case, and you won't get the benefit of surround immersion out of these two speakers. Pro Tools makes this sort of process easy with the use of their downmixer plugin. In this case, you're seeing a 5.1 track with a 5.1 output. Once I instantiate the downmixer plugin, the output becomes a two-channel stereo output. A binaural mix is more than a simple downmix. Though it is similar to downmixing in the sense that we have a surround mix that is being output through only two channels, there are a number of psychoacoustic processes applied that simulate a 3D immersive experience for the listener. There's only one catch. In order to get the full benefit of these processes, the listener must be using headphones for monitoring. You can still listen to this kind of output through conventional speakers, but you won't be hearing the intended positioning or levels. In the third tutorial, we discuss signal flow in the context of a multi-channel monitoring environment. To review, each STA UHD Producer plugin outputs 16 audio streams to the STA summing engine, which is then assigned to physical output paths in Pro Tools. Depending on which output format you're using at the time, not all of these channels will be used, and channel assignments will change with different speaker configurations. But there's one thing that remains constant. The final three channels of outputs from the STA summing plugin are reserved, and two of those channels, specifically channels 14 and 15, are used for binaural headphone monitoring. Given that binaural monitoring is so important to certain kinds of workflows, the real question remaining is how it's done. Let's talk about two easy ways that you could do it. Just to make things interesting, let me show you how I could set things up using just my laptop's built-in output. In this session, I have a single track for simplicity's sake with an STA UHD Producer plugin instantiated on the last insert of that audio track. I've got two 7.1 auxiliary input tracks with the STA UHD Producer plugin on inserts serving as outputs of my summing engine. You must assign the outputs of these tracks in order for the summing plugin to function. So in this case, I'm just using two 7.1 buses that aren't assigned to any physical output path. The first thing I'll need to do is to activate binaural headphone monitoring, and I can do that from any of the STA UHD Producer plugins on a mono, stereo, 5.0, or 7.0 track. You'll notice that as soon as I click the headphone monitoring button, the signal ceases to come out of channels 1 through 13 and only comes out of channels 14 and 15. Here's one simple way to set up binaural monitoring. Instantiate a downmixer plugin on an insert after the STA UHD Producer plugin on the second 7.1 aux. Note here that as soon as the plugin is instantiated, the output meters change into a stereo configuration. Once that's done, just assign the output of that track to the output that's connected to your headphones. This is a good method to go with if you don't have a surround multi-channel monitoring environment and will be monitoring only on headphones. What if you want to be able to monitor via a surround multi-channel setup, and you also want to be able to monitor via headphones at any time? That's easy too. Let's go into Pro Tools I/O setup window. You can see here that we have our two 7.1 buses. In a normal surround monitoring scenario, I'd have these mapped to physical output paths, but as I said, this is a setup for a standalone laptop. In this case, what I'll do is create a stereo subpath of the second 7.1 bus and move the channel assignments to the 6th and 7th channels, which correspond to the 14th and 15th outputs of the STA summing engine. I'll name this appropriately and close the I/O setup window. Now all I need to do is create a stereo aux, set the input to be our newly created subpath, and assign the output to the output feeding my headphones. Easy! The advantage of this setup is that if the situation demands it, I can have my system set up for surround monitoring and headphone monitoring and switch the monitoring setup with just a click of a button in the STA UHD Producer plugin, as you can see here. And that takes us to the end of our discussion on binaural monitoring using the STA UHD Producer plugin. Other videos in this series will look more in depth at how to set up your Pro Tools session, different features, and even some tips and tricks. To learn more, visit sonictieredu.com/learning.